Hello students, welcome to all four e-learning classes. Okay, today we will discuss about the Gauss law applications. Okay, in that first one, electric field intensity due to long uniformly charged wire. Electric field intensity due to long uniformly charged wire. So now consider a long wire. Okay, let us take this is an infinitely long wire. Okay, given a positive charge plus Q, the charge given to this wire is plus Q. Let us take this is a charge given to the wire which is uniformly distributed along its length. The charge which is given to the wire is uniformly distributed along its length. Okay, now what is, let us take if lambda be the linear charge density here. Okay, lambda is linear charge density. Lambda is a linear charge density. So already we wrote what is lambda is the charge per unit length. Lambda is equals we may write Q by L or dQ by dL. Q by L or dQ by dL. Now we need to find electric field intensity due to these long uniformly charged wire. At a normal distance r from the axis of the wire. Okay, but by using Gauss law we should calculate. What is the statement of Gauss law? The total electric flux passing through any closed surface is equals to the 1 by epsilon naught times of the net charge enclosed by the surface, isn't it? The total flux passing through any closed surface is equals to 1 by epsilon naught times of the net charge enclosed by the surface. Here only one body is a charged body. What is the charge given to this body is positive charge plus Q is given. The plus Q is uniformly distributed along its length. Now using Gauss law we should calculate the electric flux. But what is a Gauss law? The Gauss law is applicable for only closed surface. Now clearly we are saying the statement, the total electric flux passing through any closed surface is equal to the 1 by epsilon naught times of the net charge. Okay. Now by using Gauss law we should calculate the electric field intensity. Then we should construct a Gaussian surface around these long wire. We should construct a Gaussian surface. Okay, closed surface. Constructing a closed surface around the charged body is called as a Gaussian surface here. Okay, now here construct a Gaussian surface in the form of a cylinder. In the form of a cylinder here. Let us take this dotted line indicates this is a, okay, this is a closed Gaussian surface in the form of a cylinder of length L. What is the length of the cylinder is here? L. L be the length of the cylinder and R be the radius of the Gaussian cylinder. Okay. And listen, here we are constructing a Gaussian surface in the form of a cylinder, okay, vertical cylinder, okay, such that the axis of the wire is coincide with the axis of the cylinder. Okay, listen, if you are observing this diagram, what is, the wire is exactly at the center of the cylinder, not any side. Okay, we are constructing a Gaussian surface in the form of a cylinder of length L, radius R, such that the axis of the cylinder is coincide with the axis of the wire. Okay. Now, what is the statement? The total flux here, the total flux passing through any closed surface. Now, we need to find the total flux passing through this surface. This surface is in the form of cylinder. Okay. Here, let us take A, B, here C, D is a cylinder. A, B, C, D is a cylinder. Now, here if you are observing the cylinder, this is in the form of a cylinder. Okay. The top surface and bottom surface of the cylinder are circular plates. Top surface and bottom surface of the cylinders are circular plates like this. Okay. Now, this is a AB is a one of the flat surface of the cylinder. Okay. Now, first of all, calculate the flux passing through these flat surface of the cylinder AB. The flux passing through the flat surface of the cylinder AB. Okay. Let it be d pi 1. Okay. Flux passing through flat surface of cylinder, flat surface of the cylinder, okay, AB is d phi 1. Okay, because it, why we are writing d phi 1, it is not a total flux passing through the surface. Here the flux passing through the a part of the cylinder. So that here we are taking it is a d phi 1. Okay. Now what is here the d phi 1 be the flux passing through the small part of this cylinder. Okay. Let it be d phi 1. What is general formula of flux is the mathematical form of flux is phi is equals to E dot A. Now what is the direction of E here? Here we are given a positive charge or not? So, we are given a positive charge here. Whenever the positive charge is given, what is the direction of electric field is radially outwards. The direction of electric field is radially outwards. This is a direction of E. Radially outwards. You may take at any point, this is radially outwards. Here, it is also radially outwards. Okay. Normal to this wire and outwards direction. D phi 1 is equals to E dot dA. dA. What is dA be the aerial vector? Here area of the flat surface of the cylinder. See, always what is the aerial vector will be taken normal to the plane. Normal to the surface. Normal and outwards from the surface. Now this is a flat surface. Plate will be there like this. Okay, this is a circular plate. What is its normal means? This top piece is indicates the direction of dA here, normal to the plane and outwards. So this is a direction of dA. This is a flat surface. Okay, and what is this? Is a circular plate, flat surface, normal to this plane means this top piece. Now E along the horizontal direction, dA is along the vertical direction. What is the angle between E and dA? Here we may write d phi 1 is equals to E dot dA, which is equals to, we may write E dA cos theta. E dA cos theta. What is the theta value here? Theta is equals to 90 degrees. Theta is 90. What is cos 90? 0. Then what will get? The flux passing through the flat surface of the cylinder is flat surface of the first top surface of the cylinder is 0. Okay. So obviously what is the theoretically we can say that electric flux, the number of electric lines of force crossing normally through the given area. Okay. The flat surface will be there like this. Normal means the electric lines of force must move like this. But no single line is also passing normally. All are lies in the plane of the flat surface of the cylinder. So that here we got the flux is a 0. Okay. Next one. We have another flat surface here. CD is also another flat surface of the cylinder. Again write here. Flux passing through flat surface of the cylinder CD is d phi 2. It is denoted by d phi 2. Another flat surface here. Direction of E is always, this body is along the direction, what is the direction of E is radially outwards, horizontal direction. But d phi 2, now we are calculating, this part is completed, AB is completed. The top surface of the cylinder is over. Now we are calculating the bottom surface. The bottom surface, flat surface of the cylinder, okay. The flux passing through the bottom surface of the cylinder is denoted by d phi 2. What is the formula here? See here, the flux passing through the flat surface of the cylinder CD is d phi 2 is equals to again E dot A. dA, because why we are writing dA here also, or you may write dA1. Here this is dA1, dA1, here dA2. Okay, but the surface area, top surface of the cylinder, bottom surface of the cylinder having the same area. This is a uniform cylinder. Top and bottom surfaces are same. dA1 is equals to dA2. Now, what is the direction of dA2? The direction of dA2 is also normal to the plane and outwards. This is the bottom surface, another circular plate. Okay, what is a normal and outwards? Now, this is a inverse. If you take out like this, it is inverse. Now, this is a top surface. What is a circular plate of bottom surface of the cylinder? Flux is a outwards, normal and outwards. This is the direction of dA, dA2. Okay, let us take this is dA1. But actually what is dA1 is equals to dA2. This is uniform cylinder. The area of AB, flat surface of AB, and the area of flat surface of CD remains the same. E dot dA2 can be written as E dA2 cos theta. What is theta? Again here also 90 degrees. Theta is 90 degrees. When theta 90, what is a cos 90? 0. The flux d phi 2 is equals to 0. What is flux d phi 2 is equals to also 0. So here also what is the electric field along the horizontal? This is a flat surface. No single line is also passing normally. No single line is also passing normally, okay, normal to the these down. What is a bottom surface of the cylinder? As a top surface of the cylinder, bottom surface of the cylinder, what is a flux passing through these two parts will be zero. Now top surface is completed, bottom surface of the cylinder is also completed. What is the rest of the cylinder? The curved part of the cylinder. This is a curved part. Curved part of the cylinder is there. Okay, now right here, third one, the flux passing through curved part of the cylinder, curved part of the cylinder, cylinder ABCD of length L comma radius R. Okay, the flux passing through curved part of the cylinder ABCD of length L, radius R. Okay, see, this is actually, we are constructing a closed Gaussian surface, okay, like in the form of hollow cylinder. We are calculating the total flux, dividing the flux passing through the first one, AB, and flux passing through the bottom surface of the cylinder, CD. And third part is remaining curved part. Top bottom surface is completed, the curved part of the cylinder. Now, what is actually the electric field intensity due to long uniformly charged wire? Now, here we should assume the wire which is here, some part of the wire is beyond the closed surface and some part of the wire is again here also not enclosed by this Gaussian surface. But here we are saying what is the charged particles must enclosed by the Gaussian surface. So here you should take the length of the wire which is enclosed by the Gaussian surface only, long wire, isn't it? The length of the wire means up to here, the length of the wire which is enclosed by the Gaussian surface only taken as a long uniformly charged wire. Okay, means here to here. Okay, so you may get one doubt, sir, these two parts are not enclosed, means we are not considering these parts. Okay, the length of the wire which is enclosed by the Gaussian surface only taken as a uniformly long charged wire. Now calculate the flux passing through this part. Now what is the area of the curved part will be like, let us take, this is a direction of normal, this is a cylinder, normal and outwards, normal and outwards, let us take this is a DA3 be the area. Okay, now what is the flux passing through the curved part of the cylinder? ABCD of length L, radius R is d phi 3. Okay, what is d phi 3 is equal to, again what is the formula, flux phi is equal to E dot DA3. If you are observing, the DA3 and E are in the same direction, so we may write like this, that is E dA3 cos theta. But what is theta here? 0 degrees. Theta will be 0. Both E and DA3 are in the same direction. Theta is equals to 0 degrees. So what will get? D phi 3 is equals to E dA3. What is dA3? dA3 be the area of the curved part of the cylinder of length L, radius R. But here dA3 can be written as dA3 is equals to 2 pi R into L. What is dA3 value is? The area of the curved part of the cylinder is 2 pi R, R be the radius and L be the length. What is the length of the cylinder is L and what is the radius R. So dA3 is equals to 2 pi R into L. Substitute here. D phi 3 is equals to E 2 pi R L. This is the third flux passing through the curved part. Flux passing through the first part, flux passing through the second bottom surface of the cylinder, and flux passing through the curved part of the cylinder. Now we need a total flux. Okay, what is total flux? Total flux phi is equals to, we may write integration of d phi, means sum of all values, or we may write like this, d phi 1 plus d phi 2 plus d phi 3. This is a total flux. Okay, here what you will get, total flux, if you are adding all these equation, what is the d phi 1 value? 0. D phi 2 is also 0. But what is the d phi 3? E into 2 pi RL. Let us take, this is a equation number 1 here. The total flux passing through these curved, this Gaussian surface, okay, the total flux passing through the Gaussian surface of the cylinder is phi is equals to E into 2 pi RL. Okay, but already we are discussed in the statement of Gauss law. What is the total flux passing through any closed surface, irrespective of shape and size, we have an expression. The total flux passing through any closed surface is equals to 1 by epsilon naught times of the net charge. 1 by epsilon naught times of the net charge enclosed by the surface. Here what are, only one body is there, one charged body is there. Okay, what is the charge given to this body is plus Q. Okay, whenever we are calculating the flux passing through this Gaussian surface of the cylinder, here we got E phi is equals to E into 2 pi RL. but by the statement of Gauss law, okay, by the statement of Gauss law, what is flux phi is equals to 1 by epsilon naught times of net charge. Here what is a net charge? Only Q. Q be the charge given to this body. Q be the charge given to the body. So we got what is phi is equals to Q by epsilon naught only. Net charge only Q here. There is no any other bodies enclosed by the surface. Okay. So phi is equals to Q by epsilon naught. But what is, whenever we are calculating the flux, here we got phi is equal to E into 2 pi RL. But by the statement, what is phi is equal to Q by epsilon naught? So equation number 1 gives total flux passing through the Gaussian surface. But according to the statement of Gauss law, what is the total flux? Phi is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times of Q. Now compare these two equations. So from equation number 1 and 2, okay, equation number 1 gives total flux phi, equation number 2 also gives total flux phi. So what is E into 2 pi RL? E into 2 pi RL is equals to Q by epsilon naught. Q by epsilon naught. But already we wrote one expression initially. If lambda be the linear charge density of this wire, but what is lambda is equal to, there we write lambda is equals to Q by L. The charge per unit area, unit length. Charge per unit length. Q be the charge given to this wire and L be the length of the wire. What is lambda? The linear charge density is the charge per unit length. Lambda is equals to Q by L. That implies Q is equals to lambda L, cross multiply. What is Q is equals to lambda L? Substitute Q is equal to lambda L in this equation. What will get? E into 2 pi RL is equals to, instead of Q, what is a lambda L by epsilon naught. Now L cancel on both sides. What is remaining? E into 2 pi R is equals to lambda by epsilon naught. Therefore, E is equals to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught R. This is a magnitude of electric field intensity due to a uniformly charged wire. Okay, E is equal to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught R. You should remember this formula is most important. Okay, so always we cannot prove all these values. Directly you should remember what is electric field intensity due to uniformly charged wire, means E is equal to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught R. In vector form it can be written as E bar is equals to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught R into R cap, where R cap be the unit vector along the R. This is a vector form of electric field intensity. Okay, R cap be the unit vector along normally outwards in the direction of R. See, if lambda linear charge density is positive, the direction of electric field will be radially outwards. Lambda is positive, the direction of electric field radially outwards. Outwards from the charge. When the lambda is positive, when the charge given to the wire is positive, lambda is positive, then the direction of electric field radially outwards. If linear charge density is negative, the direction of electric field is radially inwards. Lambda is negative, direction of E is radially inwards. And lambda is negative only when charge given to the wire is negative. If Q is negative, lambda is also negative. When lambda is negative, what is the direction of electric field? Radially inwards. So this is an expression for electric field intensity due to the uniformly charged wire. E is equal to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught r. So the questions may be asked like this. The linear charge density of a certain wire is, a certain long wire is so and so, some 2.9 into, okay, 2.9 coulomb per meter, okay. Now we need to calculate the electric field intensity at a 5 centimeters of distance. They mentioned r value and lambda value. But by using these expression to calculate the electric field intensity, it is quite difficult because we need to substitute lambda value, 2 pi, pi value, epsilon naught value, okay, epsilon naught 8.85 into 10 power minus 12. So instead of this, we may write like this. E is equals to, it is also can be written as E is equal to multiplying and dividing with 2. What is E is equal to? You will get 2 lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught r. E is equals to 2 lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught r. Because while doing the problems, numerical problems, it is very easy. If you know the lambda and r, what is 2 is a number, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught we know directly. In here, we should substitute 2 pi epsilon naught. But here, directly 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught value is 9 into 10 power 9. Okay, by using these expression, we can calculate the electric field intensity due to uniformly long charged wire. Okay, so this is a formula, actual formula. But it can be written as E is equals to 2 lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught r. Okay, this is the first applications. Okay, see, not only for this body, you may take any object to find the intensity of electric field by these given charged body. First of all, we enclose the charged body by a Gaussian surface irrespective of its shape and size. Okay, irrespective of shape and size, we should construct a Gaussian surface, then calculate the flux passing through the different parts. Okay, then add that flux, total flux. So you will get certain value like this. Okay, this is the total flux, but according to the statement, the flux will be phi is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times of net charge. Then compare the total flux, what we are calculated, and as per statement, what is the total flux, equate them, and finally we will get the electric field intensity to any charged body. Okay.